Running is popular in a way in China that only could happen in China. We're talking about exponential growth that you can't even begin to comprehend it.
Recently, people have paid more and more attention to their health.
Lots of runners I met, they are CEO, doctor, professor.
现在从40岁往后，再没运动过。但基本来讲的话，现在一通过锻炼之后，身体基本没有说毛病了。早上呢起来就我们一般都是5点钟就起来开始跑，就像现在一样，天天跑，就每天呢坚持10公里左右。
I saw so much more involvement in running in bigger cities, what obviously Beijing, Shanghai, a number of runners and races start rapidly growing up.
They
loosened restrictions on sporting events like this, and pretty much overnight, you had events springing up in cities and villages and towns all over China.
Running is the number one activity in China for fitness-related activities. It'll be over 500, roughly 500 marathons this year.
然后呢，这个到3站、5站，之后10站，到发展到现在的15站，去年15站，今年也15站，对这样的一个趋势。
China, we have a lot of people who wants to get into the Hangzhou race. We increased the number from 5,000 to 10,000 to 15,000, which is last year's number. And this year it might be over 20,000.
然后以至于现在大部分中国的，包括像国外的一些马拉松比赛，都需要去抽签。
There are two places in the world that are growing at 300% year over year when it comes to running. That is Russia and China. In China, 300% year over year growth is staggering.
I
did the Europe, Paris, Florida, Japan, Singapore, Italy, China.
I won almost 30 marathons. I won 4 times Boston, and I won Chicago and Tokyo.
我其实比较喜欢短距离的。 体会就是我蛮喜欢瞬间爆发的那种状态的感觉，所以呢，我就开始组有跑团，我现在跑团也有300多人了，所以最重要是现在也开始影响很多人跟我一起来跑马拉松。You
have people caring about their health, people wanting to exercise, and running seems to be the most open to them.
Before I run, I'm very fat. After I run 1 year. I lost 50 pounds.
Why I couldn't finish like a milestone, like full marathon in my life. So I just, because of that reason, I want to challenge myself. I want to set a goal and achieve that.
I was working with an IT firm. I was sitting all day and I don't feel good about myself. So I decided to put on my shoes and just decided to run outside because it's the most easiest way.
越来越多的人跑，也会带动更多的人来跑，那么这个是有一个滚雪球的一个效应吧。They're
able to just buy shoes and run. The problem with that is they get injured just as easily as they buy shoes, and that's, I think, the premise of having to learn how to run.
I was elite high jumper, jumping in 70s, but I didn't run. After finishing university, I was invited to the same faculty to become teacher on the faculty, and I started teach track and field. Actually, it was a kind of humbling experience. You suddenly understood that actually you don't know how to run. I started looking for answers in many different fields of running, like athletes, elite athletes of runners, coaches, And suddenly I realized, actually, they have no clue. I have to change everything and start discovering.
Running is a basic human biomotor ability. Our thinking is that every single person needs to be able to run. You can get as technical as you want, or you can keep it as simple as you want. And I think it's that simple allure that gets everyone going.
I was lucky. 2 years only it took to get to the point that I found that actually it's a pose. Running is a pose, like any movement.
Anytime you break at the waist, you're losing potential energy because you're bending at the waist. When you stay as one single unit, you also fall much easier, okay? The pose method was founded during the last running boom in the US, which would be in the mid-70s. That accessibility to people who previously had not exercised led to a lot of injuries. We're talking 2 out of 3 runners typically get injured year after year, and this has been the case for 40 years.
They're running, they're trying to do the exercise, which is great, but then you're not doing it very well. So then you're gonna lead onto injury, and then subsequently you're gonna end up stopping.
Rather than the local authors, we want to know what is the best technique or best book in the world.
也是这个我的一位学员跟我跑步的学员，他送我一本书，这个就是书的名称就是跑步该怎么跑。
Actually, movement in running happens as a movement process by falling. Only you have to see this falling in very specific way. A pose revolution in running means we are going with the skill development first. Second, we are very well aware of what we are doing. And then proper training process.
We can now learn from the mistakes that we made in the past. We can start from the beginning, having people educated about how to run well, how to run better.
The first question Dr. Romanov asked me is that, do you run? I said, I never run. I hate running, I swim. And then I read the book and learned from Dr. Romanov the pose and what is your pose, how to land, how to fall, how to pull, and it became more easy for me to have fun from running.
我学完，我记得我是隔了2天，我就去又跑了个10公里，然后我保持的还是之前的这个配速，然后跑完以后最大的反应就是膝盖的压力没有那么大。
The difference is people, they focus more on the technique and they want to run pain-free. They want to have some injury prevention.
这个是不一样的，因为对我来说，它改变我对跑步的理解，它改变我另外一个思路。
I think if people are more informed about pose running, then I think they'll be able to continue doing the things that they love for a longer period of time. I think that's what it's about. It's about longevity.
My running, my best 10K from 37 to 34. And my half marathon from 1 hour and 25 to 1 hour and 17.
We started doing seminars. We started to teach runners in person. We started to certify coaches. And we started to also have very unique relationships with all sorts of businesses that supply the running industry.
For us, as a brand who has a long heritage in fitness as well as running, China poses a huge opportunity for us. And running is a key part of that.
我们其实我们在于就是说，我们希望为跑者作为这个切入点去为跑者服务。也就是说，我们做这样的赛事是让这个抛开产品，是让这个跑者能够享受到一个优质的这种跑步联赛。
So when we're doing the running camp, we don't want them to injure themselves. One half of fun. So post method is a good way to doing that and have more fun. You improve your health, your fitness level, and as a result of that, probably improve your productivity as well.
I get involved with running since 2014. After that, I came across CrossFit, I came across Ironman triathlon. So I get more and more involved in this fitness community.
I see it together, in parallel almost, a running boom happening and CrossFit coming to China in a big wave.
I started CrossFit 3 years ago. We are the first CrossFit box in Shenzhen.
然后刚好就有那个Post Method的课程, 然后在深圳去开设。 然后我就感觉到，哎，这个课程可以去听一下。然后因为刚好是也在 CrossFit 的网站上面听到的，所以就参加这个课程。
Running, I think, goes hand in hand with fitness. What we've seen is that runners don't strength train enough, and vice versa.
我最早跑步是因为，我第一次跑步的时候，别人说我很弱，然后就7公里就喘得很厉害。 还有那个时候我比较胖，我想减肥。
The original box we were set up on the 11th floor, so to be honest, the amount of exposure to running was fairly limited. But since moving to a ground floor space, I've done a lot more running, and I can see the benefit of doing running as well.
自从我专注 CrossFit 之后的话，就没有去跑过，专门去跑步了。我很希望，就是因为跑步确实。
通过知识跑法之后呢，我觉得跑步的技巧是非常重要的，跟举重的技巧是一样的。我觉得现在马拉松热的一方面是整个全民的这种健身的这种意识提升了，因为确实现在都市人的生活像北上广这种的，所以我身边很多的朋友原来也是胖胖的啊，然后亚健康很多的。I
own this box since 2014, which is the first affiliate in Hangzhou, and fifth. CrossFit official affiliate in China.
Most members, they don't like running, to be honest. Your heart rate goes up, it doesn't feel really comfortable, but there's nothing that can bring up your aerobic capacity like running.
And CrossFit could be incredibly helpful for runners who are usually avoiding and sometimes neglecting this part, and CrossFit could bring a strong background in strength conditioning developing for runners.
CrossFit can tap into the running community, and the running community desperately needs CrossFit. And I think that we're so pleased to see that evolving together in China. CrossFit is growing rapidly, and so are we.
There are not one thing, not one side, not one layer. It's many of these layers and many different aspects of joy in running.
我这第一方面是让我养成一种好的习惯，因为让我每天早上其实晨跑它是还是挺考验的。我现在因为工作的原因，我会有时候会出差，然后呢，我现在最喜欢是到一个城市出差的时候呢，我会首先是先问别人哪里最好跑步。
Before I learn post method, I always face the wall. I want to overcome, break through this challenge.
If you had a chance to come and visit Hangzhou, please grab a early morning time to running around the West Lake. It's more like you are running in a classic Chinese painting.
自己一个人在那很有节奏的跑步，能感觉到自己心跳的那种感觉，就是自己和自己在对话。我是很享受这种感觉。
You're expanding this capacity of what you are capable to do this, and you're discovering yourself in this. You feel powerful, you feel capable, and you get to know yourself. It's basically what ancient Greek again asked. It's the same Apollo temple in Athens. Get to know yourself.
I don't think it's just about healthy. It's about they want to be free.
就更爱自己吧，而且是一种正能量，想给自己给自己的正能量，也是社会给自己的正能量。
I want to become an artist, like a pianist or a painter. They are create something outside. I'm create something inside.
我的目标其实就是能和朋友很高兴、开心的在一起跑步。
So I get fat, I get thin, I get healthy, I get sick, but I always try to keep moving forward. And it could be a snail's pace, but as long as you're still moving forward, it's good.
Personally, I would like to say I can feel different peaceful moments in my brain and in my heart when I was doing long, slow distance running.
Moving and running and being fit can help me be better.
I see my world is bigger. Because I was just running in Hong Kong, but my world is bigger and bigger. Yeah, I run over the world because I'm a marathon runner.
Is this not the limit? Is there about how to facing your life? Why are you living in this world? And you can feel your life. I'm living in this world. I'm alive.
就是对我做什么事情我都有种坚持力跟一种毅力，就做什么事情都不会说半途而废啊，不是说希望通过比赛获得一些什么样的利益啊或者地位啊等等啊，那么更多的你要去享受这些比赛。
This is my motto. This is what keep me driving in this life, in this development. That's why I never will lose this, because every single time I have accomplishment of this kind and battery again recharge.
Every time we come to China, we hear so many stories about how running has positively benefited people's lives, whether it's reaching their goals of losing weight, personal achievements like finishing a marathon, or just even running for health and being able to clear your head.
You are basically extending yourself over your board, yourself, and you start connecting with nature. This is what we're going to Chinese philosophy. Confucius, main thing in ethic, relationship with nature. You have to be friendly, you have to be smart, and you have to be wise to be very good with nature. And that is the layers what we are going through the running.